Welcome to our official CES 2022 coverage. We're going to be making short videos like this throughout the period that CES is taking place to keep you up to date on the latest developments from the show. Don't forget to hit subscribe and the notification bell to make sure you see every single video we post. Like most outlets, we've decided to cover CES virtually this year, which also means that we spent a chunk of change on getting ready to go and then not going because COVID. So if you'd like to support the channel, check out Patreon and our other links below. Like the team here at the channel, most automakers who had planned on revealing something fun at CES made the last-minute decision to switch to virtual attendance, and Mercedes-Benz is one such company. It wasted no time in taking full advantage of that switch in plans, though, holding a reveal event earlier today to showcase its latest concept car, the Mercedes-Benz Vision EQXX. A full day ahead, in fact, of its planned CES reveal event. The 15-minute review was heavy on CGI, but unlike the previous CES concept car, the Vision AVTR, which, let's face it, was just a chance for Benz to work with James Cameron and Hollywood on an Avatar-themed vehicle, the Vision EQXX looks like it is halfway to plausible production vehicle, with a minty fresh aftertaste, I'd guess, by that name. Either that or a not safe for work sexiness. I'll let you decide. This car looks like an unholy alliance between a Porsche Taycan, Mercedes-Benz EQS, and the Lightyear One. And that's for good reason. Efficiency. The low sweeping front helps it cut through the air like a knife, while the slightly clumsy-looking cambac at the rear ensures a minimum amount of turbulence at the other end. That, by the way, is the bit that reminds me of the Lightyear One the most, all the way down to that weird light cluster. But in our opinion, Lightyear manages a far more aesthetically pleasing integration into the rest of the vehicle. There's even a solar roof, which we can't see a listed power output for, but Ben says is good for an additional 25 kilometers or 15 miles of range per day in ideal circumstances. Ben says this vehicle will travel over 1,000 kilometers, 621 miles per charge of its battery pack, a battery that the presentation says was less than 100 kilowatt hours usable. At this point, though, I think it's worth noting that unlike most concept cars, Mercedes-Benz has actually revealed a lot about the technical side of the vehicle, which means I think that it is heading towards a production vehicle at some point in the future. I'm talking about details like its 900-volt battery pack, which would mean it would charge at a 350-kilowatt charging station very quickly, as well as a 150-kilowatt electric drivetrain that has a claimed battery-to-wheel efficiency of 95%. The latter, Mercedes says, combined with a drag coefficient of just 0.17 and a curb weight of 1,750 kilos, that's 3,858 pounds, should help it sip electrons on the road. Mercedes-Benz claims a consumption of less than 10 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers, which works out to just over 6 miles per kilowatt hour. That's certainly impressive. But some of the lengths it's gone to in order to achieve this may make it harder to turn into a production vehicle. 3D printing and computer-aided design was used to remove excess material from key components throughout the vehicle, and ultra-low rolling resistance tires, magnesium alloy wheels, and aluminium alloy brake discs, or rotors, finish out the engineering notes. Inside? Well, it's much more of a typical concept car, with futuristic seats and a massive single-piece digital display that's clearly born from the Mercedes-Benz's work on the digital dash developed for the production EQS. Everything is over-the-air updatable, and of course, there are full suites of vehicle sensors and autonomous capabilities promised. This is, after all, a vehicle envisaged as a grand tourer for the brave new EV world. But there's one thing that you might not be able to get your head around, at least if you suffer from trypophobia, or fear of holes. The entire cabin is filled with tiny little holes drilled, or is that printed, into everything from the door handle to the center console. It's all in the interests of weight saving, we'd guess, but yeah, it's not something for those who break out in hives when a cheese grater Mac Pro is in the building. So what do we think? Well, the external design past the C-pillar could use some work, but overall, we think Mercedes-Benz, like any other company, should be praised for looking at more aerodynamic vehicles rather than just shoehorning massive battery packs in. And yeah, Ford, I am kind of looking at you for that one. Of course, while we had hoped to get a hands-on experience at CES, we have reached out to the folks at Mercedes-Benz and asked to get some close-up personal time. If and when we do, we'll be sure to share.